Now, geometrical interpretation of scalar triple product. Now, the scalar triple product A cross B dot C, cross product and dot product, represents the volume of a parallelepiped whose coterminous edges are represented by vector A, vector B and vector C, which form a right-handed system of vectors. So, I have just made a parallelepiped here, and again second figure just to explain the geometrical interpretation. Okay, now let's start it. Now, consider a parallelepiped whose coterminous edges OA, these are the edges OA, OB and OC. Okay, OA, OB and OC whose coterminous edges OA, OB and OC represented in magnitude and direction represented in magnitude and direction by vector A, vector B and vector C such that vector OA is equal to vector A, vector OB is equal to vector B and vector OC is equal to vector C. Now this is first thing. Then now we can write A cross B. Here I have written A cross B. Okay, now cross product of the two vectors, that is A and B. Now A cross B, this one A cross B is the vector perpendicular A cross B is the vector perpendicular to the plane of vector A and vector B. One thing, then let theta be the angle between vector A and vector B. And phi, I have made here, this is angle theta between A and B, and this phi between C and this straight line, this is for A cross B. Okay, and phi be the angle between phi be the angle between vector C and vector A cross vector B. Now due to less space I am writing in this manner, you can move this for the next line and this for the another next line. Okay, so now we are having, and the last thing, that is this n cap. Okay, and let n cap be a unit vector let n cap be a unit vector along vector A cross vector B. So this was all about some basic representation. Okay, now what we are having, we are having this format. Now we will be writing vector A, vector B, vector C is equal to vector A cross vector B dot vector C is equal to. Now what this is equal to? Now A cross B, how we are writing A cross B? That is with magnitude of vector A, magnitude of vector B, sine theta with unit vector n dot vector C. Okay, now to this what we can write it, to this part. Okay, so we can write it now, let me write here only. Now this becomes magnitude of vector A, magnitude of vector B, sine theta dot with this one vector C, and this becomes now magnitude of vector A, magnitude of vector B, sine theta dot vector C cos phi. Okay, now A B sine theta with C cos phi, this is a unit vector, so this is 1. Is it clear? Now we are left with these terms. Now what basically these terms are? Now this is equal to area of parallelogram OADB, OADB with, now what C cos phi represents? C cos phi represents a perpendicular or a height from C on AB. Okay, so first of all let me write a statement. So this will be, we can write it, length of perpendicular, length of perpendicular from C on OADB. Is it clear? Now this becomes, now this becomes area of parallelogram OADB with C. Now let this point be M, okay, with CM, where CM is equal to height of parallelopiped. Is it clear? So what we are having at the end, we are left with now, this is equal to base of parallelopiped with height of parallelopiped. This part, area of parallelogram OADB is base of parallelopiped and CM is height of parallelopiped. So this becomes what? This becomes volume of parallel open. So this is all about the result. Once again, the scalar triple product A cross B dot C represents the volume of a parallelepiped whose coterminous edges are represented by vector A, vector B and vector C, and we geometrically we have shown that this is equal to volume of a parallelepiped.